Good morning, dear students. I hope everyone is fit and fine. My dear students, I am your computer teacher, Miss Madhuri from California Public School. So students, today we will continue our next topic, that is embedded system. In the previous video, we have done types of computers till game console topic. So today we are going to discuss next one type of computer, that is embedded system. So an embedded system is the one that has a computer hardware with the software embedded or implanted into a larger device. Here embedded means fixed. Here embedded or implanted means fixed. So in this computer, hardware with software are embedded into one large device. So it comprises, here comprises means include. It include essential. Essential means important. Important computer components. Components means parts like CPU, RAM, ROM, input and output medium, but doesn't have hard drive, keyboard or screen. In this type of computer, there are some important components, CPU, RAM, ROM, for performing any type of a processing, but there will be no any disk drive, keyboard or screen. And these are designed to perform a specific task, like in TV sets, in vehicles, telephones, digital cameras, washing machines, microwaves, dishwashers and medical equipments. And embedded systems are also called microcontrollers. Basically, these systems are present inside any other equipment, any other device, larger device. Okay. So let us understand the concept of embedded computers with the help of this given example. So see its example. In a microwave oven, the role of embedded system is to take instruction from the user through the keypad and translate them into commands. How we can start microwave? How we can work with microwave? Firstly, we will give instructions to the microwave. Okay, we will set its temperature, each and everything user will set. And these commands are then passed on to the microwave to obtain the desired output. After that, that commands will transfer to the microwave to get the desired output, to get the needed output. So suppose you want to cook noodles in a microwave, you will put the ingredients in a bowl and place that bowl on the glass tray, set the timings for it and press the start button. These all operations we will do to cook noodles. So the microwave will stop as per the timing set for cooking the noodles. All this is handled by the embedded computer of the microwave. Who will handle these all instructions? There is embedded system. Basically, in the microwave, there are some circuits are there that will handle our instructions. Okay, and that circuits are called embedded system. So now next we are going to discuss mini computers. So these computers are big in size and then the microcomputers, typically being the same as that of a refrigerator. These computers are very big in size. So see its picture. So they have a higher processing speed. Processing means calculating speed, and are costlier than microcomputers. And these computers are costlier than microcomputers. So these computers are capable to support about 4 to 200 users simultaneously. Simultaneously means at the same time. At the same time, mini computers can handle up to 200 users. And they are used in banks, universities and in other big organizations. Okay, so its examples are PDP-8, HP-2100, Microwex-3100. Now next we are going to discuss mainframe computers. So these computers are very powerful. They are very big in size with a large memory and high speed. Its processing speed is very high. And they are designed to tackle huge amount of data. Here tackle means handle. It can handle huge amount of data or instructions. So more than 100 users can use these type of computers. And these computers are very costly. Expensive means costly. And are mainly used for the bulk data processing in large business organizations, universities, banks, scientific laboratories, airline and railway ticket reservations, the stock exchange markets. So these are areas where these computers, mainframe computers, are used. Like these are used in business organization for office purpose, in universities, at banks, scientific laboratories, airlines. So its examples are IBM Z series, PDP-10 and System Z-10. So now next we are going to discuss supercomputers. So as the name suggests, these computers are very powerful computers. Okay, so they are the most powerful with a huge processing speed. And these computers are used for weather forecasting, space research, satellite control. So its examples are Cray-1, Cray-2, Param, Tinhetu, Sanwe Tehulite, etc. So these are the examples of supercomputers. So now next topic, we have computer languages. As in our day-to-day life, we use languages to communicate with each other. Okay, how human beings communicate with each other using any language, whether it's English language, Hindi language, Punjabi language. So same like that, computer does not understand human language. Computer understand only machine level language. Okay, computer understand programming language. So computer programming languages now we are going to discuss. So firstly, we will come to know what is a language. So language is a medium to express our views and feelings. To communicate with a computer, we need a language that a computer understand. We know very well, computer does not understand human language, English language. Computer understand only machine language, that is in the form of zeros and ones. So for every action, a computer has to be given instructions accordingly. Yes, we know very well, if we want to do any type of work on the computer, then there is need of instructions. User has to give instructions to the computer. So now, what is a program? A program is a set of instructions that tells the computer what to do. What is a program? It is a set of instructions, okay, that tells the computer what to do. Jo computer ko batata hai ki usne kya task perform karna hai. And according to that, computer will do work. So the process of writing specific instructions in a computer language is called programming. So what is a programming? Specific process of writing instructions in computer language is called programming. How we can write program? Which way we have to follow to write any program? That is called programming. So now we are going to discuss different computer languages. So there are four different languages: machine language, assembly language, high level language, and fourth generation language. So today in this video, we will discuss only machine language and assembly language. So machine language is also known as first generation language. Okay, this language is also known as first generation language. So let's begin. It is the only language that a computer understand. This is the only language that computer understand. Okay, and it is expressed in binary form, that is in the form of 0 and 1. 0 means off state and 1 means on state. Okay, machine language is in the form of 0s and 1. And these 0s and 1s are called binary digits. So machine language has the advantage of very high speed and very low memory utilization. Its speed is very high and it occupies some memory area only. But understanding and learning machine language is tough and time consuming process. Why it's tough? Because it is in the form of zeros and ones. And human, how human will understand zeros and one form language? It's tough work. So it's very difficult to write and debug programs written in machine language. Debug means run. It's very difficult to write and debug programs. So it's also called machine dependent because only machine can understand this. So this language is also regarded as low level language, LLL, triple L, low level language. So now come on the next topic, that is assembly language. It's also known as second generation language. So after this machine language, they developed one more language, that is assembly language. Because machine language does not understand by the human beings. Okay, it's difficult to understand because it is in the form of zeros and one. So there is need to develop one more language that can be easily understandable by the computer. So that second generation language they developed, that is assembly language. So this language uses mnemonic codes or symbols in place of zeros and ones. In this language, they used mnemonic codes. So now we will discuss what are the mnemonic codes. Later on we will discuss. So for example, if the operation code for add is this one, 0010 in binary, it can be directly written as add in assembly language. For example, if we have to add binary language in binary language, then we will use 0010 for adding operation. But if we will use assembly language, then we will in place of writing this 0010, we will write a double d. So this language uses symbolic codes, hence it is easy to work in assembly language than in binary language, because this here we have used alphabets, and alphabets a human being can easily understand. So assembly language is also machine dependent, like machine language, and programming in this language is quite time consuming. So thus it is also regarded as a low level language. So in this language, if we have to write any type of a particular code, then we must learn these type of operations. Like if we want to perform add operation, then we have to write add. So same like that, if difficult operations we have to perform, then we have to remember that code. Okay, so this is also regarded as a low level language, triple L. So see this one, PC. So this is a second generation computer. So my dear students, this is enough for today. Rest of the generations we will discuss in the next video. So stay home, stay safe, stay healthy. Take care, have a nice day.